Woodland lawn Jane Doe. On a cool autumn morning in September of 1976, a man going for a walk discovered something unexpected. The partially clothed body of a woman who was approximately 15 to 30 years old. She'd been beaten, strangled, and violated. Authorities determined that this was not the crime scene. Rather, she was just disposed of on the side of the road without a care. Witnesses placed a Ford Econoline van in the area at the time, but they were never able to figure out who owned it, or if it even had anything to do with the dumping of the body. Two bandanas and a bag for grass seed were found over her face. There had been fastened behind her neck with a square knot. Eye holes were cut into one bandana, and the bag was tied over. It was actually a piece of this bag that led to her choking to death. Police have never given up trying to find her identity, and 40 years later, she was exhumed. Detectives found pollen that they believe connected her to Boston, and they also believe she may have spent some time in New York City. Pictures show what she may have looked like in life. Short brown hair, possibly in her 20s, and she did have a tattoo with the letters JP on her right arm. If you have any information at all, please call the number on your screen. So far, she has gone unidentified for 45 years. I do not show postmortem photos on my channel, but they can be viewed online if you search. The Dorchester Jane Doe. In 2005, a woman was found in a chimney of an apartment complex in Dorchester, Massachusetts. A chimney sweep had been sent to the apartment because there was a heating problem, and he made this grisly discovery. The chimney itself had been used as an incinerator in the 1960s. However, the owner of the building removed the incinerator. They refit it for an air conditioning system that was placed in that same opening. The door to the room that it was in had been left unlocked for a long time. Anyone could have gone inside, and it's believed that she may have been placed inside between January of 2002 to 2005. Her remains were skeletal by the time they were discovered. This is the first time I've ever felt a need to comment on the quality of the photos that have been provided to try to recreate someone's appearance. However, these look like a man with longer hair, and I suspect that's not accurate at all. We know she was a woman that had long brown or black hair. She had mainly Caucasian features, although she could be Hispanic, black, or Asian also. She gave birth to at least one child. She had a partial upper dental plate that was on top, and it was poorly done, as if it was acquired through a third-party means other than an actual dentist. She has gone unidentified for 16 years so far. If you have any idea who she might be, please call the number on your screen. Julie Doe, Clermont, Florida. Julie Doe was a transgendered woman murdered in Florida in 1988. Unfortunately, there was a mix-up originally, and authorities believe she was a female who had given birth. This likely had to do with some damage to her bones during reassignment surgery. So much time was lost, unfortunately, until 2015. This is when genetic testing determined that she had been born male. Carl Koppelman and some others did a great job in trying to depict how she may have looked at various transitions in her life in hopes that someone is missing her. In 1988, being transgendered was even more dangerous than it is today. She had been dragged to a concealed area of a swamp in Lake County, Florida, not far from the border into Polk County. As a result, her body became mummified. Unfortunately, the cause of death could not be determined, but because of the way her body was disposed of and hidden, it was determined it must be a homicide. She wore a bluish-green tank top and an acid-washed denim skirt. The pantyhose she wore had been partially removed, suggesting an assault may have taken place. There were no shoes, jewelry, or personal effects found at the scene. Based on the condition of her body, it's determined she had died about 2 weeks to 8 months before the discovery was made. She had long hair that had been bleached a strawberry blonde color, and they are unsure what her actual hair color may have been. She had healed fractures on her toes, one cheek, a rib, and possibly her nose, indicating she may have been abused before her death, and some of it could have taken place because of surgery. Her reassignment surgery is believed to have been taken place in either Georgia, Florida, New Orleans, New York City, or California. Her nose injury may be related to rhinoplasty. The surgery is believed to have taken place around 1984 or before, as the implants she had were discontinued in 1983. She was between 5'9" and 5'11" tall. Isotope testing was performed in July of 2018, but I'm not able to see any results that have been released. It's been suggested that as a transgender woman during the 80s, she may have been estranged from her family, and it's likely there was no missing persons report filed. The DNA Doe Project has been amazing in identifying individuals through forensic genealogy. The police did seek their services. Two attempts were funded through the project in hopes of extracting enough DNA from her bones to identify her family. However, both attempts were unsuccessful. They began raising money for a third attempt in November of 2018, which failed. However, after consulting with a fourth lab, it appears they were successful in extracting her DNA. Julie's DNA has been uploaded to GEDmatch in January of 2020, and the research is ongoing. This case also led to a special task force. The purpose being to try to be as respectful as possible, developing artistic renderings of what the decedents might have looked like prior to transition. Some have worried that it is disrespectful, but the decision was made that while they were transitioning, they may look differently, and the ultimate goal is identification. She has gone unidentified for 33 years. If you may know who Julie is, please call the number on your screen. The Perry County Jane Doe. The Perry County Jane Doe was discovered in June of 1979 in Watts Township, Perry County, Pennsylvania. She was found abandoned by a river near a highway. She had been there a few months and she was mostly skeletalized. She was believed to be between 5'2" and 5'9" tall. She had turquoise jewelry on her body, which can be seen here, and she was often referred to as the girl with the turquoise jewelry. Her cause of death could not be determined, but it was ruled suspicious. She had long remained the only Jane Doe in the area. It is thought she was between 15 and 30 years old when she died, although she may have been as old as 38. She was white, and they are unable to tell if she had straight or curly hair, but it was shoulder length, blonde, or light brown. She was thin, weighing around 125 pounds. She had received dental care during her life, and a back tooth had been removed, 4 or 5 years maybe prior to her death. She also had a number of fillings in her mouth. One tooth, which was a molar, had not yet erupted. Her teeth showed no evidence of crowding. Her teeth appeared to be quite straight, and it's unclear if she had orthodonture in her life. At some point prior to her death, her rib was fractured and healed. It is thought she lived for some time in the southwestern United States and had just arrived in Pennsylvania. Her bones revealed that she had spent time in the Midwest or in southern Canada near the Great Lakes area. She was wearing 2 sterling silver rings with turquoise stones. One of the rings contained onyx pieces that were believed to have originated in the southwest, possibly having been made by Navajo or Zuni Indians that inhabit the area. All of the jewelry is believed to have originated in Arizona. She has gone unidentified for 43 years. If you have any idea at all who she might be, please call the number on your screen. Thank you everyone for watching and listening. Any help with convincing the YouTube algorithm this channel exists would be amazing. Please comment, like, and subscribe if you haven't yet. Take care of yourselves and each other.